In this session, we are going to discuss another most important sorting technique, that is quicksort. So, as the name suggests, quick means what? It works very fastly as compared to bubble sort, insertion sort and selection sort. Why? Because selection sort takes one element and compares with other elements, as well as insertion sort makes two lists, sorted list, unsorted list, and each and every time one element is compared with the sorted elements. Whereas in a bubble sort, adjacent elements are compared. So whatever the least sorting technique you consider, that might takes much more time if you have many number of elements. But this quick sort works very fastly if you have large amount of data. The previous three sorting techniques are useful only if you have small number of elements. Whereas this quick sort and the next coming sort is merge sort, these two sorting techniques are useful when you have large amount of data only. Clear? So as the name suggests, it works very fastly and it is not a stable search. So why we are calling this is not a stable search? Now, this quicksort comparison will be based on considering the pivot element. So what is pivot element we'll see in the example. And it is very fast and requires less additional space. And it works based on the divide and conquer method. So this is a very most important topic, that is divide and conquer method. So in this method, what we do? First, we divide the things. First, we divide the list, then we merge the list. So, divide is nothing but dividing and conquer is nothing but implementation of the dividing multiple times makes the list as sorted list. So, this method we call it as a divide and conquer method. So, in this algorithm, we have to consider three steps. First one, element value must be less than the pivot element. And pivot element, that we call it as a central element, and elements must be greater than the pivot element. So here, what is mean by pivot element? Pivot element is nothing but it is an element from the available elements. Consider here, I am considering some numbers, right? 10, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. Now, all these are what? All these are called as elements. From these elements, you can consider any element as pivot element. Ante, ee unna elements lo nunchi, edaina oka element ni manam pivot element anukovali. Right? Consider, I am considering this as the pivot element. So, you need to sort these elements. You need to sort these elements based on the pivot element. Now, after the sorting, after the first iteration, the pivot element will be in the central position and all the elements greater than the pivot are this side and all the element lesser than the pivot are this side. So, these are lesser than the pivot, these are greater than the pivot element. In our example, 10 is the largest element, so the no will be considered 11. Now, after first iteration, how the elements will be? 10 will be in a such a location that before pivot, all are lesser elements. After pivot, all are greater elements. So, the elements must be greater like this side and this side 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. So, these elements must be in this order. So, the rule is not that all elements are in order. Consider if I am considering like this. Now, the elements are not in order. 2, 6, 4, 8, 9. That means the concept is that the pivot element whatever you are considering, before that all are lesser elements. After that all are greater elements. As we discussed binary tree. So, root element must be less subtree. Left subtree must be lesser. Right subtree must be greater than the root element like this. So, pivot element is like root. This is left subtree. This is a right subtree. Clear? Now, we will going into the complete step-by-step process how you are going to sort this algorithm. See, consider an example 4, 2, 6, 5, 3, 9. I have an array with the 6 elements. How many number of elements are there? There are 6 elements are there. Step 1. So what is the step 1? Consider any element as pivot element. From this available elements, you may consider any element as pivot element. It is not a rule that you should consider this one, you should consider this one. Any element you consider as a pivot element. Now let us consider the pivot element as 5. I am considering the pivot element as 5. Now L, R as the left and right pointers. So what we have to do, always this side are lesser element, always this side are greater elements, right? Now I am considering this as a pivot element, this is a left pointer, this is a right pointer, clear? Now in a step 3, if left pointer value is less than the pivot, understand this carefully, left pointer value is less than the pivot element, that means less, left pointer is smaller than the pivot, then move left pointer. Now consider here 4. So what is the first one? 4. Now here 4 is less than 5. 4 is a left pointer, 5 is a pivot element. 4 is less than 5. The condition is true. If the condition is true, what you are moving? You are moving left pointer from 0 location to first location. Clear? That means if the value is lesser, then only you move left pointer. Otherwise, you are not supposed to move left pointer. So repeat the same step until the condition becomes false. Next, consider left pointer is at first location, the value is 2. 2 is left pointer, 5 is pivot element. 2 is also less than 5, condition true, again the condition true, then move left. So here, now the value of L is at a location 3 and the value of L is 6. Now repeat the same process. Now 6 is not less than 5. 6 is not less than 5. Stop left. So you are not supposed to forward the left pointer. You stay there only. Now left pointer is at location 3 and the value is at 6. Now after completion of left, condition becomes false, we stopped the left pointer. Now after step 3, what we are writing here, if left pointer is less than P, then move left pointer, repeat this step till the condition becomes false. Now the condition is false here, so we stopped the left pointer. Now go for the next step. Now check if right pointer is greater than P, then move right pointer, repeat the same step till the condition becomes false. Now here, what is the right pointer? Right pointer is 9. So 9 is greater than 5, condition true. So move right pointer from 9 to 3. Clear? Now if the condition true, repeat the same. If condition false, stop there itself. Condition true, so we are moving R from 9 to 3. Now again check, R must be greater than P. So R value is 3, P value is 5. Is 3 is greater than 5? Here we stopped here where the left is, condition becomes false. Why? Because 6 is less than 5. No, so stop left. After step 3, we go for step 4. In this step 4, if R right pointer must be greater than the pivot element, then move right pointer. Now right pointer is at 9. 9 is greater than 5. So here 9 is greater than 5, condition true. If the condition true, what you have to do, you have to move the right pointer. So right pointer must be now at 3. Repeat the same step till the condition becomes false. Condition true, then move R to 3. Again check for the 3. Is 3 is greater than 5? No, stop R. Now here also the condition is false. Now stop R. Now we stopped the left pointer. Now we stopped the right pointer. Now at this condition, two conditions are false, right? If two conditions are false, what you are doing? Swap L, R. So whatever the values you have here at L and R, so stop here. L must be R must be here and L must be here, not pointers. You swap only the values. So that means what? 3 should come here and 6 should go there. So that what happens? The value whichever smaller than the pivot are coming this side, and the values which are greater than the pivot are coming this side. Observe here. Right? Now we'll go for the next step. See, after swapping, the least become 4, 2, 3, 5, 6, 9. Now this is a pivot element, this is at right pointer, this is at left pointer, and this is a least. Now move left and right pointer to one more step. So what will happen? Left come to this side, right come to this side. Now all are at 5. So L, left pointer, right pointer, and pivot element. Now pivot element is at same location. That means left pointer value and right pointer value and pivot element are same. Then all elements before pivot are smaller than the pivot, and all elements after the pivot are greater than the pivot. Now move one more step to L and R. So R comes to this direction and L goes to this direction. So L is coming to this side and R is going to this side. Now consider that 4, 2, 3 are one sublist. This is one sublist, and 6 and 9 are one more sublist. 6 and 9 are one more sublist. Now repeat the above all steps in these two sublists. Now consider what your our concept of pick sort, dividing and conquering. So dividing is nothing but what? I'm dividing this list in such a way that the most element, pivot element, are in the central point, and this is a right sub list, this is a left sub list. So this is left sub list, this is also a list, this is also a list. 4, 2, 3, 6 and 9. Now whatever the process we considered on this first list, whatever the process we consider, 4, 2, 6, 5, 3, 9 as pivot element, left sublist, right left pointer, right pointer, and this all the steps, same steps you perform on these two sublist. Now what will happen if you perform these two sublist? Now consider this is a left pointer, this is a right pointer, this is a pivot element. So what is the first step? Left pointer must be greater less than the pivot. So what you have at left? 4 is less than 2? 4 is less than 2? No. Condition false. You are not supposed to move left. Now go for right. So here R must be greater than P. So 3 is greater than 2? Yes. So move right pointer. So where R comes? 4, 2, 3, left pointer, P, and right pointer here. Right? Now here what is happening? Again, right pointer is greater than pivot. Is 2 is greater than 2? No. Condition becomes false. If the condition becomes false, what you have to do? You have to swap L and R values. So 2 comes here, 4 goes here, 3 comes here. So here what is there? So L is here, P is here, and R is here. Now move one step L and R. So R comes to this side and L goes to this side. Now L and R are at same locations? No. L and R are at same locations? No. What you have to do? What element you consider? Pivot element you consider as 2. Now this becomes then the pivot element. All elements which are greater than the pivot are right side. So even allowed nai right side. Then left part emaina unda? లేదు. సో పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఏ లొకేషన్లో ఉంది? దాని కరెక్ట్ ప్లేస్లో ఉంది. దాని తర్వాత ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఏమున్నాయి? 4 అండ్ 3. సో ఇప్పుడు 4, 3 ఒక సబ్ లిస్ట్, 2 అనేది పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్. ఫస్ట్ ఇక్కడ చూడండి, 5 పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఇలా ఉంచేసి దీని ఒక సబ్ లిస్ట్ చేసినాం, దీని ఒక సబ్ లిస్ట్ చేసాం. ఇప్పుడు మళ్ళీ 4, 2, 3లో మళ్ళీ అదే పర్ఫామ్ చేసాం. పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్, లెఫ్ట్ పాయింటర్, రైట్ పాయింటర్. ఇప్పుడు ఏమొచ్చింది? పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ దాని ప్లేస్లో వచ్చింది. మళ్ళీ ఇప్పుడు సబ్ లిస్ట్ వచ్చింది 4, 3. మళ్ళీ మనం దీన్ని ఏం చేయాలి? లెఫ్ట్ పాయింటర్ అనుకోవాలి, రైట్ పాయింటర్ అనుకోవాలి, పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ అనుకోవాలి. ఇప్పుడు 2 ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఏమైనప్పుడు పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ దేన్ని అనుకుంటాం? దేనే అనుకోలేము కాబట్టి ఈ 3నే పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ అనుకోవాలి. ఓకే, సో ఇక్కడికి రండి. సో ఇప్పుడు ఇది 6 అండ్ 9 చెప్తే ఇది అర్థమవుతుంది. ఇప్పుడు సిక్స్ నైన్ టూ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఏమున్నాయి కదా, లెఫ్ట్ పాయింటర్ ఇది, రైట్ పాయింటర్ ఇది, దీనే పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ అనుకుందాం. సో ఫస్ట్ కండిషన్ ఏంటి, లెఫ్ట్ పాయింటర్ ఈజ్ లెస్ దాన్ ద పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్. ఈ సిక్స్ ఈజ్ లెస్ దాన్ నైన్, ఎస్. సో మూవ్ ఎల్, సో మూవ్ ఎల్. సో ఎల్ని మూవ్ చేస్తే ఎక్కడికి వస్తుంది, ఇక్కడికి వస్తుంది. నెక్స్ట్ తర్వాత ఏంటి, లెఫ్ట్ పాయింటర్ ఈజ్ లెస్ దాన్ పి. సో లెఫ్ట్ ఎక్కడ ఉంది, నైన్ లెస్ దాన్ నైన్, కండిషన్ ఫాల్స్. సో డోంట్ మూవ్ దిస్ వన్. నెక్స్ట్ కండిషన్ ఈజ్ వాట్, రైట్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ పి. సో రైట్ ఎక్కడ ఉంది, నైన్, నైన్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ నైన్, ఇక్కడ ఏమవుతుంది, కండిషన్ ఫాల్స్. ఓకే, కండిషన్ ఫాల్స్. నౌ చెక్ ఎల్ అండ్ ఆర్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ ఆర్ నాట్. ఎస్, ఎల్ అండ్ ఆర్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ ఆర్ నాట్, ఈక్వల్. సో ఈక్వల్గా ఉన్నప్పుడు మనం స్వాప్ చేయాల్సిన అవసరం ఉంటుందా, ఉండదు. సో ఇప్పుడు మన ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఎలా ఉన్నాయి, సిక్స్ నైన్ కరెక్ట్గా ఉన్నాయి. సో ఆర్డర్లో ఏమైనా ఉన్నాయి, ఇప్పుడు దీన్ని మనం స్వాపింగ్ చేయాలా అవసరం లేదు. సో ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఫోర్ అండ్ త్రీని కూడా మనం ఇదే స్టెప్స్లో చేస్తే ఏమొస్తుంది, త్రీ ఫోర్ వస్తుంది. ఫస్ట్ ఇక్కడ టూ ఉంది, తర్వాత త్రీ ఫోర్ ఉంది, ఇక్కడ మధ్యలో కంటిన్యూషన్గా ఏది వస్తుంది మనకి, ఇక్కడ మధ్యలో కంటిన్యూషన్గా ఫైవ్ వస్తుంది. నౌ కన్సిడర్ ఆల్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్, టూ త్రీ ఫోర్ ఫైవ్ సిక్స్ అండ్ నైన్. క్లియర్? నౌ దట్ మీన్స్ వాట్, వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఏ లీస్ట్ అండ్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఏ పైవట్ ఎలిమెంట్ అండ్ వీఆర్ డివైడింగ్ దట్ ఇన్ టు సబ్ లిస్ట్. అగైన్ వీఆర్ పర్ఫార్మింగ్ సేమ్ స్టెప్స్ ఆన్ ద సబ్ లిస్ట్ అండ్ ఫైనల్లీ వీఆర్ మర్జింగ్ ఎంటైర్ లిస్ట్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ ఫ్యాషన్, టూ త్రీ ఫోర్ ఫైవ్ సిక్స్ అండ్ నైన్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ అ ఫైనల్ సార్టెడ్ లిస్ట్.